Guys, this is Mark. In this video, I'll be talking about data binding in UI Builder. We talked about it in some of the previous videos, but it is such an important subject when you work with UI Builder and when you create dynamic user interfaces that I thought I'm going to dedicate yet another video where we explore that data binding from slightly different perspective. What I will be demonstrating in this video is a variation of the image gallery in my previous video, and you can see a link to it on your screen right now. And in there, we talked about the row component. We built that image gallery. I will demonstrate now what it looks like. And in here, the page loads a bunch of images and just displays them in a gallery style. So all the images here are rendered in the multi-line fashion in a single row. There are three categories of these images. We have people, we have food, and we have nature. And these images are grouped by these categories in the file system where I retrieve them from using Backendless API. And what I thought I'm going to do is to apply slightly different technique where I can display those images in different groups. Let me demonstrate the final result first of what I am going to achieve. This is going to be the final result that I will demonstrate. And here, as you can see, there are three groups: food, nature, and people. And each group contains the images that correspond to that group. So this is going to be the final result, and you will see how easy it is to achieve this effect and build an image gallery like this. Of course, as we go, we will be exploring other things such as selecting an image and zooming in and getting some additional details just so we can start using this particular example. And I'm sure there will be other examples, but for now I will focus on this one. And in this video, we will be building this particular effect where images are sorted by groups. Let me go back to UI Builder. And rather than exploring what I did here, is I will take the original one, which is row demo. That's the one where all the images are displayed in a single row. And I will create a fork from this, and then we will be modifying it as we go, which, by the way, will be useful because you will see how to fork a page, or essentially create a copy of this page just so you can do some additional modifications. To create a replica of this page, if you move the mouse over this area and select new page, in here you will type in the name of the new page. I don't know what we're going to call it yet, but in the create as select fork, and select the page which you will be making a copy of. So in this case, I will be making a copy of row demo. And I will call this container and row binding. And you will see why I called it this way. So click create, and now we get exactly the same replica, but of that page with a different name. So let's change the title, and we will call it image gallery. And in here, so what we have, we load all the a listing of all the files in the page load event handler on the page enter. As you can see, we get the listing of directories of all the pictures that come from the server, and then a single image renders them. We need to change this mechanism, but before we do this, let's explore what the structure of the file directories is on the server side. Go to backend, select files. And in here, in the pictures directory, I have three subdirectories: food, nature, and people. And inside of these, there are images that correspond to food, nature, and people. So that's the structure, and it is important for the sake of this demo. The general approach that I want to implement is I will retrieve just the directories first. And these directories will be bound to my rows. So the rows are going to be replicated, and each row will contain a block for food, a block for nature, and a block for people. And then inside of each row, I will have that image that renders only the files from that particular directory. So to do this, first of all, let's change the page enter event handler. And rather than loading JPEGs, we're going to load just the star because we are interested only in the directories. And then include subdirectories, change to false. So in this case, from directory pictures, we will load only its contents. And those are going to be just the directories, because if you remember, in here we had food, nature, and people. So we're going to load these three. And let's go back in here. What this will result is it will retrieve, in this case, three objects. Each object will represent a directory, and that will become the data model of our top level container. And let's check what this top level container is. So this is container one, and let's call it gallery container. The gallery container will need to have dynamic list behavior, because it will start replicating rows for each directory that we received from the server. So let's make sure that we have binding to gallery container at the page level. So here we're going to change it to gallery container. Now, if we go back to gallery container, we want to provide a header that will display the name of the category or the name of the directory that that it will represent. So in this case, let's add a row to our container. And in this row, we will place the text component. And this text component, let's make this a little bit larger font, let's say 30 pixels. We can remove and make the cell size a little bit smaller. We don't need the padding at the top. We can leave the padding at the bottom. And we can also make the cell to take up the entire width. And also in our cell, let's just select the actual row. Let's give it a slightly gray background color, just so it looks like the actual header. So this text needs to be bound to the name of the directory that comes back. So click text and then go to the logic for this text. And in the data binding, it's going to be bound to the property called name. And then I will show you why it is going to be name, but specifically the objects that come back that represent directories, each object will have a name property that contains the name of this directory. That's just how backendless APIs work. So now this will display proper name. Now in the pics gallery, what we need to do is for each directory, so let's say we receive directory and it says it is food. So for that directory, we need to retrieve all of its children, because right now we're just retrieving top level directories. But then for each directory, we need to retrieve all the images. And that's where the magic will happen, because right now, if we launch the page, all we will see is just the headers for individual directories. Let's, by the way, take a look at what it looks like. So as you can see, we have food, nature, and people, but there are no images. Let's take a look at what we receive on the wire. Network, reload. So here's the API call, and as you can see, there are three objects. Okay. Notice that in each of these objects, there is a public URL that represents the URL of the entire directory. And there is this internal URL that references that specific directory in the backendless storage. And it is the name of it is URL. So for each section in here, for food, for nature, and for people, we want to retrieve all the files from URL. Once again, that's because that's how backendless APIs work. So how do we get all the pictures from each of these URLs? Let me demonstrate that. So in here, this is our pics gallery row. As you can see, this is row, pics gallery. If we click to go to logic, one of the handlers is called dynamic items logic. And in here, we haven't used it yet, but in here, we can retrieve images for that specific directory. And let me show you what that will look like. And previously, we used data binding, but data binding doesn't apply here because the data is not there yet. So far, all we got is just the specific directory information. So now we need to load files from this directory. And that's going to happen in the dynamic items logic. And in here, notice this return connector. So this return is supposed to return the actual collection of all the objects that need to be rendered by this specific row. And we will use backendless APIs to load files from to actually get directory listing. we will be retrieving all JPEG files. And then the path is going to be this URL object. So what we will need to do is get the object property from PixGalleryData. Notice that the PixGalleryData is going to be the actual one of these guys. So this object right here, like the zero, this object right here is going to become PixGalleryData for row zero. This will become PixGalleryData row one, and so on. So we want to retrieve property URL, and that will get the listing of all the files in pictures/food, pictures/nature, pictures/people for each corresponding row. That's all it really takes. Now, as far as the binding on the actual image, that this stays the same. So if we go to logic, the public URL will be binding to a specific object that represents an image at this point. And at this point, it is ready. So we have two directional binding, one that goes top to bottom in the top container, in the gallery container, that will replicate these rows as the template. And then we have left to right data binding in each individual row for the images. Let's run it and see what we got. Reload this page. And as you can see, we have this behavior exactly as what I started with. We have three categories, and then each row contains all the images from that specific directory. I think it is pretty cool because the amount of logic that we had to add is really just minimal. And the UI in the designer looks very simple, and then the effect is actually pretty cool. As we go, we will be modifying this image gallery to make it more feature rich and cooler. There is so much more that can be done, but right now we're just kind of creating these building blocks in form of this learning of how to build with UI Builder. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you found this useful. And as always, happy coding.